Hello, and welcome to another episode. In this episode, we're going to mod Skywatcher Motors to use a 6-volt lead-acid battery, rather than using the D-cells that we were using before. The problem with these D-cells was using the rechargeable types, and they're only 1.2 volts each, which means it's equaling 4.8 volts instead of the required 6 volts, which means the motors are underpowered. This was causing a lot of slippage in the image was creating on the in the telescope, where it was slowly moving out of view. So let's get on and mod those motors. Okay, here is the Skywatcher power pack that comes with the motors, and this is where the D cells go in here. So, with looking at this here, you can see that the positive side is here. It's connected to this yellow wire. So I'm just going to make a note. So yellow positive, so we'll have no issues later on. Now my plan is just to chop off the wires here and then connect it to the battery. Okay, first a quick snip here to free the wire from the casing. So I'm just going to cut these as close as we can to the root here. So we're going for the positive wire. Okay, we've cut and stripped the wires here. So now we're going to solder the negative wire to this inline fuse. And the reason we're doing this is because I did see if we could try and get around this and not bother, but all the advice says that if you're going to use a lead-acid battery, it really means an inline fuse in case there's a short circuit and sudden surge of current which could destroy any delicate equipment attached to it. Is the wires ready to solder? So it's been about 20 years since I've done any soldering, so this may be an absolute disaster, but let's give it a go. And there we go, the wires soldered together. To finish this off, you're going to want to put some tape around it, some electrical tape, just to make sure that it's not going to short circuit anything. Next, we're going to need to connect the wires to the actual terminals. And to do that, I chose these crimp connectors. And you can see there they've got like a slit there. And this goes over the terminal like this. And slides on. This allows you to pull them on and off and then leave them there so quite securely without any worries. So you want to know what type of battery terminal you've got. This is F1, and then get the matching crimp connector size. It's all you can look all that up online. So now we're going to use the crimping tool to connect the wire to the crimp connector, so it's all secure. So just get your crimping tool. And squeeze. So it's secure. Then do the same again on the negative terminal. The negative wire. Finally, we need to put the fuse in the inline fuse holder. I chose a 1.25 amp fuse just because a 1 amp was too close to the theoretical amp consumption of the actual motors. So I was worried that in a long astronomy session, it might blow, and then I'll be trying to change the fuse in the dark, which would not be a great situation to be in. Both ends of the wire should now end in the crimp connector. And we can now connect these to our battery. The final step, as you can see, is to connect it to the battery. And we've done so here. Of course, we're going to need a case or something for it, but that will be a later task. When I was using these rechargeable batteries, and I was using the controller, the light on the controller would blink red and green continuously. At the time, I thought that was normal, but I came to realise this was because it wasn't getting sufficient power. Now with 6 volts, you can see that when it's tracking, it's just constantly red. It's not going green at all. So, problem solved. For another episode, folks, I hope I've inspired some of you guys out there to convert some of your battery packs to a lead acid battery pack. Of course, the advantage is you can charge it as many times as you like, which saves you money in the long run, and it's got a lot longer amp hour, so it can go for longer at full power. If you like this video, please give us a like. If you've got any questions, please leave a comment. And if you like more astronomy videos, please subscribe. Goodbye and clear skies.